You guys can still talk. You're fine.
Nah, dog. You gotta do your Monday medication. Hurry
Tom,
up.
Tom, where? It's 1 o'clock in the morning. It's technically Monday. So, hi, I'm Eric. This is Frankie. It's Monday Medication. It's the last Monday of April, and I originally thought that we should just kind of recap everything that we talked about the past month, but I'm too lazy to do that. So I just pulled up two things that are happening right now, because one is a huge one with Steam and the mods. So now apparently you can pay for mods, or I think you have to pay for mods. I'm not too sure. I haven't really looked up on this all that much. Everyone else in the ward has, except for me, but do you know a little bit more about it than I do?
Man, I don't feel like talking.
I do. The way it's working right now is they're only using it on Skyrim. And basically, you can developers or mod creators can have their mods cost money.
What are you talking about?
And they can have their mods cost money. And basically, the internet is outcrying because mods have always been free. It's been one of the main reasons to
get a PC.
Yeah. Mm. And a lot of mod creators are fighting back, creating dumb mods, or charging ridiculous amounts. And I think today or yesterday, Gabe Newell, CEO, or I don't know if he's the CEO. Valve.
Lord Gaben,
yeah.
As everyone calls him. That's all you need to
the
say.
The main head of Valve had an AMA on Reddit to ask some questions, but it was all like, all CEO stuff just to be like, oh, this is for, not, we're not censoring people, this is a good thing, and just anything to like slide people away. And then he kept on talking about like, just money, like, oh, it's a good idea to get the mod creators to get money. A lot of people, like many websites where you get mods, have a donate button, and that's what people mainly want to get.
Yeah.
In Steam, a donate button instead of just charging.
Yeah.
Because it's right now it's in Skyrim, and this is also Bethesda. Bethesda also wanted this apart, and 75% of the money goes towards.
Yeah.
Valve and Bethesda, and only 25% goes towards
the creators. Yeah,
which is
so
insane.
It doesn't really seem like it's better odds than what it really should be. I'm kind of all for the donate button instead of forcing someone to pay for probably a stupid ass mod for a game. Like, if you want a pony in a game, don't force them to pay like $5 to $10 for it. If you want to give them money for however good or crappy that mod is, that would be fine. But I don't really think you should just force people to pay for it.
Yeah, right now it's only Skyrim, but other games are already being like, yep, we're going to jump on that, and we're going to have paid mods, while other games are like, no, we'll never support paid mods. It all depends on the developer.
Mm-hmm. The other topic that I wanted to bring up was the whole Silent Hills debacle, and how it's pretty much, I'm sure it's canned. So, everyone knows about Kojima. He left, and Guillermo del Toro finally put that nail in the coffin and just said it's not going to happen. He even said it breaks his greasy heart that it's not going to happen. I'm a little heartbroken as well, because I was excited to see where it was going to go, even though I don't think it'll be scarier than the PT demo itself. That thing was terrifying.
If that game came out with Kojima, it'll probably be good. Kojima's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
It was gonna be nothing like PT anyway.
No.
Even if it came out. But once Kojima left, it was just like a downhill spiral. Spiral. And
it's too late for this.
Once Kojima left, if it did come out, it would probably be like a shitty Silent Hill game, which is basically all of them. Because Silent Hill sucks.
Past three, yes, but I
Silent
did enjoy
Hill sucks.
One and two were extremely good. Three was all right, and then past that, it was just all meh. That's what he thinks.
All suck. just like Kingdom Hearts.
You know what sucks? Persona.
Oh my god. Take that back. Every day.
Yeah, I know.
It's great at your Junus.
But?
You don't even know. But now it's never coming out. So yeah, we'll never know.
So we're not gonna suffer in case if it did turn out to be fucking terrible. It's weird seeing 5-year-olds when I work in GameStop coming in. Oh my god, look, it's Daryl, the action figure. You're 5. You should not be watching that. You
should be playing Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah.
If that's a child's game.
I don't even know if that's appropriate. Is that appropriate for a kid?
No.
Kingdom Hearts? Yeah, you play in your gummy ship.
Riku!
You remember the Entitu? They were having a gay beach party in the ocean with Donald and Goofy.
Oh, that's right, they were.
You know what I mean?
Carlos. Carlos, if you're watching.
I remember
the
game in 8 hours.
Remember the hearts.
Black Ops 3. I watched. I skipped around the trailer, so I don't. I know.
The only good part of that trailer was that they put painted black in there. That's it.
I heard that it has like your robot now, and that's cool.
That's cool. But the only thing is, towards the end, it was like a 2-second clip, but they showed you running on the wall, shooting people. That's Titanfall. The fact that there's robots everywhere now, Titanfall.
Did you talk about,
it was worse.
Battlefront?
I haven't talked about it yet. I think I mentioned it on a Friday video, just because it was like one topic and I just said, well, Battlefront. But everyone else is talking about it, so I...
Everybody's pretty disappointed about it.
A little bit.
This is about all the stuff that's coming out of it.
Isn't the first DLC free, though?
Yeah, just to calm people down, because there's so much that they announced, and like, yeah, here's all the bad stuff about it. Like, there's no instant missions, there's no galactic conquest, I don't think, there's no space battles, you can't ride in the AT-ATs!
Wait, what? That's a thing?
This is dumb.
Yeah, that's pretty dumb. It's being developed by DICE.
Less maps.
I think it's 20v20 now. It's not 32v32.
There's so much that they're removing. But, and people are upset that, like, oh, this is completely not Battlefront. I'm pretty still excited because, in my mind, I'm just feeling like, I'm just thinking that this is not Battlefront. This is the sequel to Battlefield 2032, which was my favorite Battlefield, the one in the future.
Yeah.
So as long as I think about this as a sequel to that one, I'm still happy.
Yeah, I still have not a Battlefront played game. That, unfortunately.
It's great.
Yeah, I've heard it. But yeah, Battlefront's happening, obviously, everyone knows that.
Anything else? Do you guys have anything? Yeah, Rich, do you want to defend Kingdom Hearts?
Not right now.
No.
Another day, I
it's impossible.
So when do you think Kingdom Hearts 3 is coming out?
I thought
the same day as Halfway 3.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. Wait. I think that's it. I'm Eric. This is Frankie. That's Rich and Mario over there.
Bye.
Yeah. Quack quack.